If you've seen some of the finalist projects and you've heard some of the things you've seen in the keynotes, you know that innovative agencies throughout the world are doing amazing projects by going digital. They're improving efficiencies, they're reducing costs, and more importantly, most importantly, they're producing fantastic results. Going digital is no longer a luxury. It's a necessity to address the challenges that I just mentioned. And it's a great starting point to creating digital twins that allow us to optimize and more efficient operations. This digital twin sounds fantastic, right? Well, how do we get one? Projects around the world are creating digital twins in a variety of ways. They might be collecting point cloud information, bringing in reality data, and integrating with geospatial information for supporting planning. They're using purpose-built design tools for road and bridge for creating conceptual and detailed design that hold lots of great intelligence that's great for internal collaboration and external stakeholder engagement. And to take this digital twin up a level, or maybe down a level, they're integrating subsurface information to really get a better understanding of the ground conditions, which is really key to avoid problems in the field. And all of this data, more and more data, allows us to make better and better decisions. And as a leading contributor to carbon emissions, one of the most important decisions we have to make is the carbon footprint of our designs. And on projects of scale like rail and transit, where you're dealing with rail infrastructure, signage, track, and adjoining infrastructure like substations, every decision we make better results in an overall productivity and better results for all. And as you can see, as we talked about, the importance of the data below the ground cannot be understated. This is where the biggest challenges, especially on tunneling projects, can be. And by integrating the data from above ground and below ground, users are making amazing projects happen. The Tecne-Systra-SWS project is an example of where digital twins above and below ground are not only creating the next generation tunnels, but they're increasing efficiencies by more than 20% and saving over 27 million euro in the project. And speaking of covering large area geographies, a project that we saw in the bridges and tunnel categories, QK4, was able to digitally survey and model and communicate 3D data for more than 700 bridges. And with almost a 90% reduction in survey time at half the cost. You heard about this in the keynote earlier. Now, these two digital twins can be used to better design and build bridges to connect communities in need. The scale of these projects are extremely vast, with many disciplines involved. It's critical to organize the data, secure information, but make it easy to use. It means being able to use this data in whatever format you need, whether it's 3D in the office, or maybe 2D plants and profiles for those that are more comfortable with that, or just extracting data for insights, like being able to see in calendar view whether your project is on time and on budget. So again, it's all about getting the data the way you need it to get the job done right, and get it done right the first time. You might have heard about the Jakarta MRT project, where these practices reduced equipment usage that resulted in less than 50 tons of carbon emissions on the project. And it's expected to reduce carbon emissions by up to 50%. Now, these are the types of projects we need to do if we're going to tackle the types of challenges we talked about earlier. We know that understanding the carbon footprint is very important, but as you heard earlier, it's very difficult to do, it's time consuming. And this is where tools like carbon analysis are a game changer, bringing in more information into the digital twin and being able to extract intelligence from that allows us to make the best decisions on our projects. And for the Northeast Link program in Melbourne, Australia, Spark and WSP are working in a collaborative fashion. It's saving them over 1,500 hours in collaborative modeling and also saving in time and materials waste as well. And with our recent announcement of the cesium acquisition and the partnership with Google, you can just imagine regardless of the scale of the project, being able to bring data together at scale means we can do amazing things in projects like this. So all of the information we've collected so far allows us to do things like understanding how quickly our bridges are deteriorating and whether remediation plans are needed. And in rail networks, the insights from the digital twin can tell us how smooth the ride on the track is or where maintenance needs to be done. Again, it's all about getting things done right at the right time. And this can all be done all while the railway continues to be operational. And just like in design and construction, being able to bring that geotechnical data allows our inspectors to access information they can't even see, again, allowing us to make better decisions. And on top of that, being able to tag information in context of everything else, or bringing in data from third-party providers like TomTom, or accessing dashcam footage and then analyzing with our capabilities like Blingsy, means you can do things like spotting a tire on the road before it causes an accident. And being able to see this at a road level, a city level, a country level, these are the possibilities that are out there. And as population continues to change and shift, as we heard about in the cities breakout, we need to do a better job of understanding how that impacts our transportation network. And Transport for London's Elizabeth Line project is a great example of how they're using data to do just that. By analyzing current demands, they're able to more easily forecast future needs. TfL is seeing better outcomes for the entire community. The project is expected to reduce carbon by nearly 25 million grams per day by reducing car journeys. The challenges for the industry, we can't overstate how significant they are. You've heard that all week long. But so are the opportunities, and we can't understate those either. Today, we'll meet leaders from the industry who have both the skill and the will to tackle these challenges. They're going to talk about how going digital is a great starting point for creating digital twins that affect the entire life cycle of projects and ultimately providing better outcomes for the public. So at this time, I'd love to welcome my colleague, Alan Esguerra, to the stage, who will lead a panel discussion with Julian Fuda from New York State DOT, Andy Kayala from WSB, and Bruce Irwin from Parsons. So welcome them to the stage, please.
Well, thank you all for joining.
You're welcome.
Yeah. Okay, we'll have a little bit of fun here.